You can create pie charts in Rguroo for factors, also called categorical variables, using data that is either in raw form or in the form of a frequency or relative frequencies. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using two datasets: the fishing dataset, which is from the ecdat repository, and the hair eye color dataset from the rdatasets repository. If you need assistance loading any of these datasets, please reference our video, Uploading a Dataset from an Rguroo Repository. From the Plots toolbar, click on the Create Plot dropdown, then scroll down to Pie Chart. Let's start our first example by loading the fishing dataset. Within the Factor dropdown, we are going to be using the categorical variable Mode, which represents the recreational mode of choice for fishing. Since we have raw data, we are not going to be using the frequency dropdown for this dataset. In Rguroo, the labels of factors are referred to as the slice labels, and the counts and percentages are called value labels. By default, Rguroo places the percentages of each factor level inside each pie slice, and the slice labels are displayed horizontally outside the slices. The location of these labels can be changed using various options in Rguroo. The legend is also defaulted to display the factor level names only. However, I'm going to hit the value radio button to display the raw counts for each factor level. And finally, I'm going to title this plot Mode of Fishing. When you are all ready to display your pie chart, hit the preview icon. Here we can see the relative proportions of the four modes of fishing, and because we asked Rguroo to do so, we also see their raw counts in the legend. Now, the hair eye color dataset comes in the format of 32 rows created from a three-dimensional array, resulting in the cross-tabulation of 592 student observations. Those counts are tallied within the frequency variable. For example, there are 32 students who had black hair, brown eyes, and were male. We are going to create another pie chart displaying the proportions of the four hair colors, black, brown, red, and blonde. Head over to the Plots toolbar again, click on the Create Plot dropdown, and then hit Pie Chart one more time. Select the hair eye color dataset, and then choose hair as our factor. Just like our last example, also click on the value radio button in the legend section. Now, due to the structure of this dataset, you will need to use the frequency dropdown to get the correct output. If you preview the results without using the frequency dropdown, you will get a graph that looks like this. Here the pie chart tabulated how many times each hair color appeared within the hair variable, which now became an even distribution. Scroll back over and click the Basics button. Under the Frequency dropdown, select the frequency variable. Let's also title this plot Proportions of Hair Color. And then let's hit the preview icon one more time. We can now see that a majority of the students that were observed had brown hair. To finish things up, I'm going to save this pie chart as Student Hair Color, so that I may reference it later. If you would like further details and examples on how to create or alter pie charts, we encourage you to reference the chapter, Creating Pie Charts, from our user guidebook.